I learned something about margaritas recently. I was scrolling through my Twitter feed and I came across a post by my friend Tian. A casual day of making margaritas and hanging out on the beach ended in this. Cool, won't be attending any of my meetings today.
Oh my God. Yeah.
Can you see that?
Oh. Yes, I can. Yeah. So wait, how many days out is this from when you made the margaritas?
3 weeks now?
Tian was just hanging out with family at the beach, sitting under an umbrella.
And I decided to make a batch of margaritas. So I hand squeezed 8 or 10 limes and then immediately brought them out to the beach where we hung out for the entire afternoon.
Seems pretty harmless, right?
I had a kind of a semicircle here. It was slightly red, but it didn't really feel like anything. All day long, we were thinking, did you put your hand out in the sun? Was it sticking out of the umbrella or something? And then the next day, it started to really heat up and it kind of swole up. And then by that night, I basically couldn't sleep.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I couldn't even bend my fingers because this whole back of my hand started to swell up. And blisters formed all over the back and along my fingers as well.
That really painful looking burn is called phytophotodermatitis, and it's caused by a combination of lime juice plus light from the sun, a combo that actually damages your DNA. When the DNA in your cells is damaged, your cells will self-destruct. That's called cell apoptosis. And I forget what I was gonna say. Cool, I shouldn't have had that margarita. Great choice. It's often a critical way for your body to stop cancerous tumor growth or stop an infection from spreading. If you're making a margarita, there's a good chance that lime juice will get absorbed into your skin. From there, compounds in that lime juice called sorolins will wedge their way into your DNA. Your DNA has 4 types of nucleotides: adenine, cytosine, guanine, and thymine. And sorolins weakly interact with all of them. They don't react with DNA, they just kinda hang out there. That process of a molecule wedging its way into your DNA is called intercalation. This intercalation is not a big deal until you're in the sun. Several wavelengths of radiation from the sun will activate sorolins, so they form covalent bonds, mainly with thymine. That covalent bonding breaks the normal interactions between thymine and adenine, damaging the DNA, so then your cells self-destruct, like I mentioned earlier. That is what happens when your skin gets covered in lime juice and is then exposed to the sun. And it leads to this uncomfortable situation you see here.
My sister is a physician's assistant, and she used to work in a dermatologist's office. So we were just sitting around, it was after dinner, and she was washing the dishes. She turned around and was like, "Did you get any lime on your hands?" And I was like, "Oh my God, the margaritas." And everyone just started laughing, and we were like, "This would be so stupid." my sister was so proud of herself for making the diagnosis.
And that's a true sister form where she's like, "I know you're sort of in pain, but I think I figured out what happened to you. So kudos to me."
Yes.
The advice for phytophotodermatitis is to treat it like you would a really bad sunburn. But remember, we are a YouTube channel, not a doctor. So if you think you have phytophotodermatitis, definitely talk to your doctor.